In this class, we are going to discuss about combinational circuits. So generally, combinational circuit is a circuit whose output will depend upon the input variables. As the name indicates, the output of a combinational circuit will depend upon the combination of input variables given. So generally, this is a logic circuit which is having different logic gates inbuilt integrated in a circuit. So see here. Here the output is dependent upon combination of input variables and it doesn't use any memory. As this is only dependent upon input combination and it's not going to depend upon any previous state inputs or any other. Here it doesn't require any memory and previous state inputs won't have any effect on the output of this combinational circuit. And it can have n number of inputs and m number of outputs. That means you can have n number of inputs for your combinational circuit and you may have m number of outputs. So this is the basic block diagram of a combinational circuit. Here you are watching n number of inputs and m number of outputs for this combinational circuit. Here the inputs are always called as excitations for combinational circuits and output is called as response of circuit. So here these are the best examples for combinational circuit. Those are adders and subtractors. So these adders and subtractors are binary adders and subtractors and decoders. So which decodes input into output. So here multiplexers are there and code converters which converts one code to another code. Like for example, if you want to convert BCD to binary, binary to BCD, BCD to gray code, if you want to design gray to binary, like that. If you want to convert one code to another code, you need code converters. These code converters are also an example of combinational circuits. And another best examples are comparators, which can compare two or more input combinations and they will provide output. And here ROM, read only memory, and PLA, programmable logic array, and PAL, programmable array logic. These are all the examples of combinational circuit. So in the next class, we'll discuss what are the designing steps in a combinational circuit. In this total combinational unit, circuit topic, we will discuss how we can design a simple circuit by using combinational circuit design logic. So in this class, you just keep in mind about combinational circuit as it's only depend upon input variables. It's not going to depend upon any other previous state inputs or outputs. And as it is not dependent upon previous inputs or outputs, it won't require any memory. And finally, it can have n number of inputs and m number of outputs. So this is about simple introduction for combinational circuit.